Shortly after arriving in Manila from his Bangkok trip, President Rodrigo Duterte paid his last respects to the late Senator Leticia Ramos-Shahani early Thursday. The president personally offered his condolences to Shahani's family and met with the late senator's brother, former President Fidel Ramos.
Ang napag-usapan namin kay Presidente, aside from the gratitude of the family for whom I spoke, because I am considered the foster father of these three orphan children, was the success of his mission to Myanmar and Thailand.
The state woman's remains were brought to the Senate, where incumbent and former senators paid tribute to their colleague. Former Senators Aquilino Pimentel Jr., Rene Sagisag, Wigberto Tañada, Ramon Magsaysay Jr., Eherson Alvarez, Santanina Rasul, Juan Ponce Enrile, and Orly Mercado were among the late senators' colleagues who attended the service. Many of them described Shahani as a calm, dedicated, pro-people, and an exemplary senator. They also described Shahani as a patriot for defending national interest and an astute defender of human rights who defied the Marcos dictatorship.
I learned from Manang Leti that the important thing in life we can ever be is to be kind.
I can only say that the Senate was blessed by a selfless and dedicated presence there as a lawmaker for two terms, and so was the country.
She looked at lawmaking, siguro sama na natin politics, as more of diplomacy and consensus building rather than confrontation.
A senator from 1987 to 1998, Shahani handled the Senate President pro tempore post from 1993 to 1996. Among the landmark laws Shahani authored were the Magna Carta for Small and Medium Enterprises and the Foreign Investments Act. One of Shahani's last public appearances was during a media forum last year, when she criticized President Duterte for not acting like a statesman when he visited Japan.
Siyempre, yung mga Hapon, ang inaasahan nila, wag naman mag-chewing gum.
She passed away at the age of 87 last Monday, losing her battle with colon cancer. An internment will happen on Monday to be followed by her cremation. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.